everybody, and welcome to World War Wrestling Battle at the Barn 2020, episode 5. And to kick off the show, I'm joined by the antisocial Ash Draven. Ash, thank you for joining me at this time. Now, we know in the past few episodes of Battle at the Barn, you've had some kind of a run-in with Alexander Roth, or his alter ego, as I've been told, by the name of Rothmore. Now, what exactly is going on between you two? I mean, I know you've got your sights set on the heavyweight championship, but I know that, you know, there's a little bit of business going on there between you two. I mean, can you elaborate for me, please?
There's nothing going on, Jake. You and everybody else is making much more of this than it truly is. Rothmore, Alexander Roth, whatever he wants to call himself, I have no business with him. My goal and my sight is on one man, and one man only, the man beast, the war beast, even the war beast. Real proof. That's what I want. Rothmore offers me nothing. There's no reason for me to get involved with Rothmore. He'll have to give me a reason if he wants to.
Shit! Hey, oh, right.
That for a reason.
Okay, puppy dog, do you want to play?
Episode 5, and things are really starting to heat up. For the longest time throughout Battle of the Barns 2020, Draven's focus has been solely on the hunt for the War Beast, the World War Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, the Champion of War, Will Cruz. Following their attack by Roth, however, albeit temporarily, Draven's focus seems to have shifted from that of the gold to that of more of a wolf hunt. As you know, each and every week we take you back in time. We take you back with matches and moments from the original Battle of the Barns series of shows. This week is no different. This week we take you back to the end of a huge war, a defining rivalry here in World War Wrestling. A rivalry that had been building since day one back in 2014 when World War Wrestling first started. This was a rivalry between two fierce women that basically started the World War Wrestling women's division. It would be contested between the Amazon, Aisha Raymond, the bombshell from hell, Scarlett, and it would take place at the first ever Champions of War. To add that little something else to it, Coxie decided that this match would be for the first ever World War Wrestling Women's Championship. This match would decide our first ever Queen of War. So let's take you back to that moment in time and back to that match and see who it was that became our World War Wrestling Queen of War.
Ladies and gentlemen, right now we are about to crown our first ever World War Wrestling Women's Champion!
Oh, Nicholas, are you ready?
Born ready, Dan, but if it's all right with you, I think I'll move a little bit further back because, well, Aisha scares me.
And here is that beautiful World War Wrestling Women's Championship. Look at that.
Of one lady, but who is it going to be? Well, now we are about to find out.
That is one beautiful belt.
I tell you something now.
In one of the most prestigious rivalries in World War Wrestling history.
Prestigious rivalries? Prestigious? Fearful! Scary!
Okay, Dan, if you could not antagonise her this time, that would be, that'd be good.
She is the Amazon, Aisha Ray!
And here we have the Amazon Aisha Ray, London's own. She's from Stratford, and let me tell you something, okay? She survived on the streets of Stratford. She took out many a man just for fun. She'd walk those streets terrorizing everyone. That's why she's called the Amazon. She's a one-woman Amazon. She's not Amazonian. She is an Amazon herself. And let me tell you something. The Amazon Aisha Ray, she always delivers. And she's going to deliver on her promise of becoming the very first World War Wrestling Women's Champion. You got this! You got this! She doesn't care what I think.
None of us do.
She is.
But I can safely say 100% she scares the hell out of
me. She scares the hell out of everyone! You got this! I believe in the Amazon Aisha Ray.
She still doesn't care what you think.
The negative about Amazon Aisha Ray as a champion is that in order to get there she's got to go through Scarlett, and Scarlett's called the bombshell from hell. And if you've ever been to Stratford and Hackney, the area of which of London that Aisha Ray has grown up on and lived on, then let me tell you something, that place can also be described as hell. So this is not an easy challenge, and this feud has been going on since the very beginning of World War Wrestling, is that not right?
Yes, since day dot. When Aisha, out of nowhere, turned up just to attack the bombshell from hell. Unprovoked, I should add.
Yeah, look, you and I have different definitions of unprovoked.
Was the Amazon supposed to be there?
Yeah, of course she was. She's the Amazon Ayesha Rae, and she's going to own the women's division.
We'll see, Dan. There's Scarlett in the way
no,
of
No, I'm
tonight.
Just saying that was her reason for being there.
And that's how it all started. And tonight, it'll finish with one of these warriors with that belt around their waist.
And right now, as we're looking at the World War Wrestling Women's Champion, it's right next to me right now. It is a beautiful belt. And it's going to go to the woman who survives this war. Will we finally see an end to the rivalry between Scarlett and the Amazon Ayesha Rae?
We have to. That's why this match was made. Commissioner Cox called this match one last time.
Oh,
the match to end the rivalry.
Oh, crap, they're outside already. They are outside already.
This is just descending into chaos.
If they come anywhere near us, I'm getting the hell out of here. You can call this by yourself.
Well, I think I'd be gone before you.
Yeah, you know what? You probably would be. And
hell hath no fury like a woman scorned, and these two are pretty.
That was an interesting move. I have never seen anything quite like that handspring. Whoa, face first into the side. Again, that is the hardest part of the ring. And she is dead weight now.
The referee needs to stay in control here.
And a gut wrench suplex onto the outside of the ring. Again, that is the hardest part of the ring. Oh, she caught her! She caught her and runs her straight into that steel post. And she's holding her against it and then dumps her down. This is vicious. Whoa! And as if she hasn't been hit. Oh my God. All right, they are here and I am getting the hell out. They are, okay.
The ref needs to get control of this quickly.
Yeah, okay. They are.
For the sake of our fans, if anything, they're crawling everywhere.
Yeah, that's.
Ref, you need to sort this quick.
I'm just keeping back here.
Well, safety in numbers and all that.
Baseball slide dropkick. Scarlett catches the feet. Scarlett catches the feet there.
I think it's wishful thinking.
Oh my word! Okay. Can I just point out that this floor, this is concrete. Like, this is the cheapest carpet you've ever seen in your life. And pure concrete. I don't even think there's underlay. All right? That's how cheap this is. And they just got dropped solid onto this concrete.
There's no underlay. Somehow, the Amazons on their feet
first. This is just the cheapest carpet tiles I've ever seen in my life.
How is this still going on?
There's no give. This is just pure concrete. And now just into that steel barricade there. They are at my favourite point of the venue right now, which is the other side of us. Which
as far away as possible,
this is
thankfully.
The safest I have felt all throughout this match. Now they're getting into the ring as if that's going to do anything. Oh, actually, Amazon Ayesha Rae is smart. Yeah. She's deliberately wanting to keep it inside this ring now. And look at that. She stands in between either side of the ropes there and applies that chin lock. Oh, and it didn't work. One, two. She had to break the pinfall there. She's
How
turned
much punishment
it,
has
she turned it into
back
a
taken.
Body scissors.
How is she able to do that after all that punishment to her lower back?
And Scarlett is in that body scissors. And Amazon Ayesha Rae is just squeezing away. Well, she turns it around. And a count there. Scarlett. Oh, and then just takes that big forearm right to the back of the neck. Another one to the shoulder blade. Scarlett fires back. Series of elbows to the midsection. Big headbutt right on the nose. Oh, wow. No, that was hard on the nose. Oh, Ayesha Rae can't see. Ayesha Rae's holding that. No, she can't see. Oh, she's just shaking it off. And
I think the headbutt took as much punishment on Scarlett on that one, but
that
was something she had to do.
That was a solid headbutt right to the bridge of the nose. She's out of the corner. And sends her into that opposite corner. She's out of the corner. Wait a minute, she goes for that shoulder charge. Scarlett catches her and now is wrapping her legs around.
Will Scarlett win with this before?
Oh, no way! One,
what's doing now?
Two, and kicks out.
We've actually seen the bombshell from hell actually win with that move before.
Yeah.
At the first Battle of the Barns.
My goodness, that head scissors dropped Scarlett. Sorry, Amazon Ishiro straight on the top of her head. And that was 2 feet right to an area where it will hurt. She hooks that leg and no. Both these girls are exhausted. They've gone full pelt, 100 miles an hour, straight from the very start. Both of them, they're going to be like wondering what they're going to do next, because like, how can you keep up this pace? They're going to be exhausted, taking time to get breath.
The amount of punishment they dished out before they even got
and
in the ring, Dan, was unreal.
Aisha Rae challenging Scarlett to come and get her. Amazon Aisha Rae challenging her to come and get her. As she holds herself in those ropes. And both are now standing.
Tell me how bad you are!
Big forearm strike. And a returns right to the shoulder. Oh, right to the chin. Oh, right. Aisha Rae felt that. Aisha Rae follows through.
And another headbutt.
Another headbutt. She catches that. Oh, eats the toes right to the throat. Oh, Aisha catches the scissor kick, picks her up.
What's this going to be?
Oh my goodness!
Powerbomb.
Two. She got it.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner.
We have the very first ever World War Wrestling Women's Champion, clean in the middle of the ring,
Aisha Rae!
This rivalry has been fierce, brutal. The start of this match was absolutely mental.
Let me tell you something now about Amazon Aisha Rae. She is a champion of numerous promotions around the UK and Europe. And she's just added another title to her collection. And let me tell you something, she's dominating the scene. She is without a shadow of doubt. Now she has that World War Wrestling Women's Championship. No one can claim to be better than her. She is at the top of the food pyramid of World War Wrestling.
She is. Dan, why is Scarlett laughing?
I have no idea.
I love Scarlett, but she just seems to have gone, what?
Maybe.
What's going on? Why is Scarlett laughing?
I don't think she's quite all there. Scarlett, though, stuck their hand out, and Aisha Rae spat at it. Aisha Rae doesn't need your respect because she's got everything she needs in the World War Wrestling Women's Championship.
Aisha Rae!
Without a shadow of a doubt now, but these two are tied now, no?
This was the match Commissioner Cox booked as the end of the rivalry. And it all came down to this. Whoever won this match would walk away with the Women's Championship. So, where does Scarlett go from here? I don't know. I honestly don't know. But it was one hell of a rivalry.
It was a hell of a match. Like, they just went at it full power right from the start.
There we have it, our first...
And our first ever women's champion of World War Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is the main event of episode 5 of Battle of the Barns. It is scheduled for 1-4, and it is a four-way war. Introducing first.
So folks, it's the main event time. And this week's main event is a powder keg that is going to erupt over your screens. Nick, we have got four of the best and brightest stars in World War Wrestling.
There's no other way of describing it. It is just going to be a war.
Four-way war. Corey McRae picked up a victory in the main event of our first episode at Battle of the Bands 20... Battle of the Bands? Battle of the... Oh, there we go.
Yes, the Battle of the Bands 2020.
Hashtag.
We had our first wrestler into the ring and introducing competitor, Hamasu.
A four-way war, yes, but it's just ref stand back and just let beat the hell out of each other.
This is it, Corey. Cody, the ref is just in there to count the pinfalls, that's not a lot else.
All right, knowledge just submission, that's it. Just literally stand back and let him go.
Entrant number two in this absolute powder keg that is filling up. Kieran Corrupt, the civilized citizen, one half of the hit set.
And introducing competitor number three in this four-way war.
Save his life.
Nick, we are halfway there to filling up the powder keg.
Civilized citizen Kieran Corrupt, who was obviously fortuitous in his victory, but got the victory nonetheless. This is a completely different proposition, a completely different type of match. Four men, four corners, every man for himself.
Of course, Xander and Kieran Corrupt going to war in episode 2.
So yeah, there's already a bit of history in this match.
Kieran Corrupt somehow got the victory after weathering the storm that was Xander.
And introducing the final
competitor. Jake says the fourth and final competitor.
The man that celebrated his birthday with us in the previous week, only to have his face filled in with cake by Jack Torino of the Rebellion. Obviously, this match is like none of these people have been in before. Ali Okay has actually beaten the four-way war before. It was an elimination match. He actually won on that day, but it wasn't Ali Okay as we know him now.
That's a new beast altogether. So four men.
Wait. Pick a corner, guys.
Pick a corner.
Well, at that point, it was actually Kid Karate that won the match on that night, and he kicked Carl Rathmore so hard in the beard that it split it in half.
Look at you!
The veteran. The pro.
How many times did you wrestle last year?
I've forgotten more about wrestling than you know, mate.
You know what? I believe Ali Okay when he says that.
What's that MMA, bro?
Who are you? Huh? What's this? World War Z going on, little man?
What is that? And you?
You're meant to be some goth daddy? What a load of rubbish. I tell you what, you're dead, the lot of you.
Oh, triple super kick! Somebody invited the silverback to a super kick party.
Anyone has ever done that? Made a cup! Better than your super kick, mates! Way better than your super kick, buddy! World's okay, super kick! Alright, just shut up.
Oh, there's super kick for Ali, okay! And then there were two.
it was, and we are down to the two that faced off in the first battle of 2020.
They're up. Zander back to going one on one.
Corey McGregor on the outside, ringing still in his ears. Ali O'Kay on the outside. Zander's not messing about, he's not even taking the hat off. He's just hell bent and beating him up.
Sinclair Crumb looks at him and says, you can keep your hat on. But dumps him to the outside. Oh, that hat's come off. That's it, game over.
Hat's off now. It's off.
Yeah, hat's off.
Is anyone's ball game at this point?
Oh, suicide dive! Kieran Corrupt takes down Zander.
And Ali O'Kay returns to the ring apron to find an empty ring.
But I don't think that's going to stop Ali O'Kay.
Where's he going?
He's calling for it.
Uh-oh.
He's gone up to the top rope.
Oh, no.
My goodness! Diving splash from the top rope to the outside. Takes down both Zander and Corrupt.
Corey McCray's back on his feet.
And he's okay!
Corey McCray's back on his feet in front of us, though, so that's good.
Come on! And as you said at the start, Nick, not a lot that Cody can do right now.
I think at this point in the four-way war, it is just a case of stand back and the butt whipping commence. Oh! I'll break your hand.
Yep. Oh.
Corey McCray re-announcing himself into the fold here.
Oh, roundhouse kick.
Straight to the cavity of the chest.
I want to do that. The roundhouse kick.
He didn't quite have the same sting, but at least he tried. That's a broken ankle. Right, so if you're keeping score, I think that's probably a broken hand and a broken ankle for Zander.
Zander gets taken down by LAK. Now, folks, I'll just reiterate, actually, this is a four-way war. This is going to be extremely hard.
Hang on a minute.
For just me and Nick to keep up with. We're going to do our best calling this action, but it is going to be sheer chaos. We get community chaos. Well, this is war.
Ali's got the toys out, so obviously it's no disqualification match at this point. Oh, that made my ears rattle.
Yeah, you got a headset on.
Obviously not noise cancelling. Corey McCray tried to cover up there, but couldn't block it completely. So, I never thought I'd ask this question as a wrestling commentator, but who was in the bin? Was that Corrupt?
I'll be honest, I think it must be. Oh, Zander comes in. He's got a... He's got a bicycle!
He's got a push bike!
He's got a bicycle!
He's got a bicycle!
Yeah, that's what I said.
Was that Zander screaming?
I think so.
Did somebody steal his bike? Corey McCray has got Ali O'Kay.
Oh, backdrop suplex to the apron, which is the hardest part of the ring.
No messing about from McCray. The hoodie's off, and now he's just going to hurt people. If toys are involved, if toys are legal, it just makes the deadly weapon that is Corey McCray even worse. But where'd the bike go? I'm assuming it was Corrupt in the bin because you haven't seen him for a while.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
And now Corey McCray being beaten down on.
It's not a bad plan from Ali O'Kay and Zander. Take a man out at a time. Literally, if they start working on Corey McCray. Well, that descended into chaos. But the point I was going to make was if you actually take one man out, then it leaves you down to two or three, which is easier to win a four-way war if there's less competitors active in it. But what's he doing? Well, that's one way to damage an angle.
You put a bin over my head, Ali! Bin over my head! Can't believe that! Ridiculous! Well, what else have we got?
Uh-oh. Zander is that as soon as the toys were introduced, he suddenly picked it up again.
Yeah, you know, it's had a bit more pep in his step. And this one has definitely broken down.
It's definitely broken down, but Ali OK got sort of his eyes washed out for him there. Xander's getting his head kicked in by Corey. This is fucked. I wasn't going to guard rail.
Ali's grabbed the guardrail.
No.
I don't think we need to be taking the set down with human bodies, Ali. I'm not claiming this mess up.
Oh, bacon tree off the skull of the OK one.
Xander checking his authenticity there.
And Xander right now, as soon as the toys are put out, like you said, business is picked up for the goth daddy.
Bell of the Barnes Ball at the Great British Bake Off. There's definitely an Ali face imprint on the back of that bacon tray.
Great British Barn Off.
The Barn.
Oh, cross body. One, two, and Corey McRae makes the save.
I could actually go for quite a bit of money on eBay. A bacon tray with Ali OK's face on it.
If he hits him hard enough, get Xander's face imprinted with that face paint. Oh, vertical suplex.
Almost a stalling one there. Look at the redness on Ali's chest.
Lighting up like a traffic light.
I don't actually mean the ink either.
And both the men just stacked up in the corner. Corey McRae's right for the picking right now.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. Wait. Uh-oh. I don't know where this is going.
He looked prone. He's going straight for the...
Oh my goodness, hesitation drop kick. Pulls Ali to the middle, one, two.
Given the positioning that he insisted on the legs, was that a double wishbone leg split?
It was doubly painful, whatever you call it.
I don't know what's more painful, that or what's happening to the OK one now. He's just picking him apart at the minute. He has him at his mercy.
He's got that hammer lock in deep.
Deep between the shoulder blades.
And Ali OK rolls through. That's the veteran instinct of Ali OK.
Going for the pin.
One, two.
Xander back in from nowhere.
Xander breaks it up.
That's the thing in this four-way war scenario. You have to have eyes in the back of your head. It's not just about the man that you're facing in front of you. It's the two others that are lurking.
Meet Mr. Xander.
Oh, wait a second.
Wait a minute.
Oh no, me too.
That's gimmick infringement.
Oh, I've been warming him up for you.
Uh-oh.
What? Get him out! Get him!
You said hello to my new friend!
Oh! So I see the Zander fucking stronger, Ali!
Wait, hang on. Is this a test of strength with stocks?
Double socks on again, meeting in the middle.
Right, so is this a test of strength with socks?
I think it is.
Well, I always found that cotton were better. With an elasticated waistband.
Greco-Roman sockle lock.
I'm glad you said that, because I wouldn't even get to collapse that.
Oh, that's a shot. Oh.
I've heard of a rock off, but never a sock.
Oh! Well, there's a few sayings right now, but you know, I'm not gonna go with them. That was unfortunate. You definitely want to wash that sock now.
Just burn it. Where it's been and where it's gone, just burn it.
Snapmare takeover. Oh, neck whip. Into the jackknife pin. One, two. Broken up from Corey McRae.
You'll actually notice though that when Corey McRae broke that up, he hesitated for a moment and picked just where he's going to put his foot.
Oh yeah, absolute precision. Absolute precision.
Maximum impact. Now he just tosses Ali OK out of the ring. Followed his sock, I think.
Thrust kick from McRae.
Yeah.
Oh, flapjack!
Yeah.
Oh, and a back senton to boot as well.
Like a cat, Ali OK is back on. He's going up top. Going up top. He went for the crossbody again.
Corey McRae just caught him, plucked him out of midair.
Supreme power.
Wait. Couldn't quite hold him though.
Ali OK slips out the back. Into the guy. I mean, what I can't really appreciate is the thickness of Corey McRae's arms when he slams him across your back.
Oh, he picks him up. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, package pile driver. Perkins pile driver. 1, 2, 3. That's it. Corey McRae continues his assault.
Oh, puts his boot straight through the chest.
Have I made my message clear yet? Just because there's no crowd doesn't mean I don't stop putting a hurt on people. Where's my hammer?
Ladies and gentlemen, there's your winner of this week's main event, the silverback, Corey McRae.
Sanders on the outside looking worse for wear, but the person I'm most concerned for now is Ali O'Kane. He doesn't... I don't know what hurt him worse, the fact that he had a baking sheet wrapped around his face, or...
Well, that was a four-way war. Join us, folks, next week for our grand finale, where we're going to have Ash Draven taking on Rothmore and so much more. The champs are not here, but the troops can come out and play. We'll see you next week.